We've covered a lot of material so far, so let me show you an example page that brings together many of the concepts we've seen. I won't take you through this step by step, I just want to show you what's possible. I'm starting back on my test page in the WebHMI. I just have a simple button pointing to a remote power panel, but in a real project, I would expect this to be a terminating point on a one-line diagram. Clicking the button opens my branch circuit page, which is the first thing I'd like to point out. While we've been focusing on pop-up pages, the invoke function also applies substitution to full pages. On the page, I'm looking at two different devices. On the left is the main meter for my RPP with a few common values. On the right, I have all the circuits of the branch circuit meter monitoring the first panel. I'm displaying the current and energy for each circuit, and if the current is over the programmed alarm value, the field here will turn yellow, then red. I can also click on the row and set a name for each channel. Finally, at the top of the page, I can click between the four different panels. So how did I do this? Let's start with the equipment in my database. The first five should be clear enough. I have a main meter and four panels. Do take note of the names. They all end in RPP name dot the device name in a consistent pattern. Each panel also has an associated disk device. We'll discuss disk devices in another video, but these are dummy devices using the IEC 61850N driver that are always in memory mode. To this, I've manually added string variable tags to hold the different channel names. Now let's go to Graphics Editor. In test.tgml, the button is the standard component and link snippet. For the component name, I've set the equipment name, but only down to the RPP level, not the individual device. I also added the substitute names property and assigned the PNL01 string to a substitution panel. We can see what this does in rpppage.tgml. The main meter values are straightforward enough. They are standard bindings, but I'm taking the name of the RPP that I passed in and attaching both the final portion of the equipment name, meter, as well as the item name. I can do this because I'm creating a standard that the main meter of a panel will always be called meter. The branch circuits work much the same way. For current and energy, I'm combining both the RPP name and that panel name with the item that I want to read. The alarm state rectangle works similarly. The device has tags indicating when the channel is in a warning or alarm state. And I have a global script that reads those tags and sets the rectangle's color based on their states. While we're here, to set those channel names, I just copied out the script contents from the User Input Write Operation button and changed the prompt text. The data point attribute is attached to the group object. Last, the panel selectors at the top. These are also groups using the standard link script. I set the group's name to the equipment substitution that will be set when we enter the page from the one line. And substitute names is the panel that I want to open. The highlight in the back is just an invisible rectangle with a unique ID set. When the page is opened, the top-level script reads the panel name from the TGML object and sets the visibility accordingly. You may be thinking that setting all these parameters for 42 circuits is a lot of work, and while you're right, I only created one circuit, then copied it to the other locations. I then wrote a PowerShell script to find the groups and increment their numbers. This is outside the scope of this course, but I want you to remember that TGML is a text XML format, so there are efficiency tools available outside graphics editor. Before we finish up, I have some final comments. Please don't think this page is perfect or even complete. I focused on the basic functionality of a branch circuit display, but I'm sure you can build something much more attractive and useful. It's not enough to have the tools available. They must be comfortable and convenient to use. You may need additional features on your page, like additional alarm displays or configuration options. Keep thinking about this while we move on to other topics. Thank you.